All right, guys. Welcome to this video. Right, this video I'm gonna be showing us how we can take our business online. All right, now that we have our products with us, now we've learned how to import products from China. We've understood how to import products. All right, that's not the end to it. The end to it is to make sales. The end to it is to start selling. Is to start selling rather, not to have your products, you know, stuck in your room. Okay, so the very first thing I want us to be doing is to create a Facebook page. Now you might ask, why do we need a Facebook page? The need of the Facebook page is to help us run a Facebook advertisement for our products. Yes. Because without having a Facebook page, you can't run a Facebook advertisement. So the very first thing we need is to have a Facebook page. All right. Of course, what we need the page as well is to have a fan base, have an audience, have a community, if I would want to say, of people that would like our product, people that will probably recognize us. All right. But the most important thing about having a page is to run advertisement with the page, not to have the page and upload your goods on it. All right. So let's just get started, guys. Of course, I believe you know the basics. I believe every one of us here can create a Facebook page, but nonetheless, we're gonna still be doing it together here, okay? So I'm on my PC right away now, right straight up. So the first thing you're gonna be doing is what? Hit over to this create. Okay, all right, it will allow us to have several things we can create, all right? Meanwhile, there's not my ad account, or rather my Facebook account. All right, Facebook can be mad at times, but I needed to make this video, so I needed to improvise. All right, so let's move on, guys. Head over to page. Right, so the first thing we're going to be doing is to have a page. We need to have a Facebook page. What's going on? Hold on, guys, let me refresh the page. All right, bravo. So it's still loading up though. So now we need a page. What do you need your page? What's the page name? All right, these things here, guys, are not quite tricky. It's something you can just do. I mean, you have the product you want to sell, you can just think of the page name you want to give your page. All right, but since we are dealing with physical products, like more of e-com products, I'll just have to do something that can cover a page. Alright, when selecting a page, you might want to be specific at times. Most of the times, you might want to be general. Like, for instance, I've seen most persons selling some product on Facebook. For instance, let's say the product is maybe herbs or herbal stuff like that. Find out that they tend to have their Facebook page name to be coined around herbs, you know, something like herbal, blah, 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 and stuff like that. I'm meaning that they might not really be able to use that page to run any other ad except on that. But at times you can have a general page name that can cover, that wouldn't limit you from running an ad. I mean, you can use that the same page to run ad for several kinds of physical products. All right, this is also more linked up to when you're buying a domain. When you're buying a domain, you could go with a specific domain name, you could go with a general domain name, which, when you have a specific domain name, it allows you to sell a specific kind of product in your site. All right, but when you have a general domain name, it allows you to sell all kinds of different products on the same site, because the name can cover for all of them. So let's not talk much, guys. Let's get into this. So let's just give up our page name. Let's call it ecom products, or let's just say fast sales. I don't know, or I have to choose this. Does this make sense, guys? Fast sales stores. Okay, maybe it makes a little bit sense now. Alright, so this is the page name. Alright, of course, we know that this is product and services. Okay, alright, you can say that product and services website as well. I don't know if there's anything like that. E-commerce, rather, yeah, e-commerce website as well. So this is for that. Then you can just come here and give them a little description of what your page is, guys. So the very first page you can give your hold on guys. So guys, so you can just find a name to give to your page, or the description rather. You can just say something like, of course the description has to be more detailed. All right it's important you would have a very well described page for your Facebook. Okay, so I'm gonna say welcome to fast sales stores. Here we sell all kinds of physical products. It's with a different, it helps. Alright guys, you can just come up with some stuff that, you know, can blend in with your page. Alright, I just had to just do one or two things here. Oops, network. Hold on guys, let me resolve this network. Let me see if it's gonna work. Alright. Okay. Hold on guys, hold on. Yep, the page has been created, guys. Alright, so what you might want to do here is to come to your page. This is the page you've created. See guys, I strongly recommend that we have a picture. Alright, a picture, first of all, a cover picture, and at the same time a profile picture, if I want to call it, for our page. When you come here, don't rush this thing. Take your time to carefully structure your page. Alright, of course you're gonna have to add a button here, guys. It's very important. You might want to add a call button, maybe send message button. There are different buttons you can add there. I would prefer you add a send WhatsApp message. Alright, okay, I think there's an option for that. Hold on, I think there's an option for send WhatsApp message. Don't just send message or send WhatsApp message, but nonetheless you can just look for something that's, you know, suits you very well, guys, and you do that. Okay, just arrange your page, put every details everywhere and all that, guys. The numbers, set everything up here, guys. So after you've done that, guys, I want you to do something very wonderful. Make sure you invite all your friends. Okay, invite all your friends to like your web page. Okay, this is very important, so at least it can also increase your page engagement, you know. Right guys, so after you've done this, the next thing I want us to do is to create an ad account. Usually from having a page as this, guys, having a page as this, you might want to, so one of the mistakes most persons do is that they, not necessarily a mistake, but if they want to run an ad for their products, what they usually will do is they will come over to here and they will run ad from their Facebook page directly. All right I don't know why most persons do that, but honestly guys, that wouldn't give you the best. All right there's a lot of stuff you may not be able to see. All right so that's when this video, I'm going to be showing you, this is quite cool, but I'm going to be showing you the more better way you can run Facebook ad. I mean, if you want to run your ads, you need to have a business Facebook. All right this business Facebook that will help you to understand your audience. All right because on normal base, most person will come here, create an ad, and they'll just, you know, they'll create an ad and that'll be it. But there's a lot of you can get from there. So what I recommend is that you don't run your ad from this particular page. All right if you want to run your ad, you can have a business page Facebook. All right to go to your or sorry guys, to go to your business Facebook, you can just simply go to type on facebook.com/business, right? Okay, yeah, facebook.com/business. Oops. Oops, sorry guys, I think I'm gonna say business.facebook.com/facebook. Or am I missing some stuff here, guys? Hold on. Right. Oops. This is not what I'm looking for. Not what I'm looking for. Thank you. So it was facebook.com/business. This should be what I'm looking for, guys. Yeah. So this is it, though. So you can just go to facebook.com/business, right, to create your ad account. But if you have any issue doing that, the easiest way you can do this is while you're still on your Facebook page. Okay, hold on, guys. So guys, like I was saying, you're gonna need this. If you wanna create the account, I'll just recommend you the. Create your account instead of going to Facebook Business. Of course, if you come here, it's going to give you the opportunity to create a Facebook account, to create a Facebook Business account. So the best way to do that is actually to come here to create and add. All right, it will direct us to our ad manager. Okay, guys, it will direct us to our ad manager. To direct us to our ad manager, guys. Bravo, right? So this is the ad manager. This is a fresh ad account, actually, guys. This is how actually it should look like. Okay, so it is your duty now to actually start scaling up your ad, guys. Scale up your ads, you know, from this end. All right, so what I want us to do here is to, this way we'll create an ad. All right, so let's say we're running an ad for a particular product. I'm going to be showing us how to do that as well. So just hit over to create an ad. This will allow us to run an ad. All right, so the basic thing about this stuff is, let me just go over with all these stuff. When you'll be needing a conversion ad, all right, is when probably you have a website installed. When you have a website, right, you can run a conversion ad, you know, other than with maybe your WhatsApp, other stuff. And of course, if you want to run an ad on brand awareness and other stuff, but majorly one of the ones I actually work more with me for here is traffic, engagement, and web conversion. These are the three major ones I use. All right, so let's just say we are running an ad. All right, so let's just proceed, guys. Okay. So these are our ad campaign. These are how our Facebook manager looks like, guys. Okay. Of course, the first thing you need to do is to give your campaign a name. All right. So what are you running for? What product are you promoting? Which product can we actually promote? Okay. Let's say we are going for spin brochure. Spin hurricane brochure. Yeah, spin hurricane. I'm gonna show us the product soon, guys. But let's say that's the product we want to run ad for. Okay, now the campaign objective is our traffic. Okay, all right, so let's go to the world how to get target our audience. Hello. All right, of course, give your ad. This ad sets a name. All this is an unnecessary important thing here, guys. My major focus is that I want to show some stuff I work with here. Okay. This is where you would have to target the people you are selling your product to. Now, the product we just selected that we were running for, that we want to set up ad for, is a spin brochure. Meanwhile, let me show how the product looks like. Okay, just a minute. So this is the product, guys. This is the product. This product is actually doing magic in the market. It's one of the most it's actually among one of the hot products you can import and make a lot of cash out of it. Okay, so this is the product. For instance, we picked and we want to promote, want to sell. So we are assuming that we actually have this product with us, guys, right? We are assuming that we have this product with us, okay? And what we want to do is to sell this product to our audience, all right? So the very first thing I want us to do is we'll download this video. Of course, you know how to download this video. If you want to download this video, we have to copy the URL of this video, whichever way we want to do that. Copy the URL, sorry guys, excuse me. Copy the URL and maybe go to, what's it called now? Either Y2 mates, yes, Y2 mates, Y2 mates, or save from net, whichever one you go to that works fine for you. You just do that and download this video. So what you do here is paste the link of the video. Okay, of course, select the, what's it called? Select the one you want to download. So already I have this video on my laptop, so I don't need to download it. All right, so after you've done this, guys, let's go back to our ads manager. All right, so after you've done that, now the first thing we did here was that we created our page. Let me just recap a little bit. I don't know if I'm running too fast. So the first thing we did, that we had our product already on set. All right, we had understood the basic of importation. We imported our product. So we took, for example, for a case example, we assume that the product we have on ground is spin brush, all right? That's our product, okay? So we went to Facebook and okay, we created a page for Facebook on Facebook, all right? And we called the name of that page Fast Sales Store, all right? That's the name of our page. So while on our Facebook page, we decided to create also a Facebook business account, all right? Which it did, and it brought us really to this place, okay, guys. So, and we're here, so we want to sell this product to our audience, all right. Let's say, for instance, we imported about 50 of this product. I don't know the exact cost of that product in the market, like in 1688, all right. But let's say we imported these 50 pieces of this product and want to sell it. And we've tried putting this product on our status, on our WhatsApp status, and you know, talking to our friends about it, and nothing is coming forth, all right. Now we need to push this product online to people that wants this product, to people that needs this product, and people that wants to use this product. All right, hope you're following, guys. So that's the thing we want to achieve in this particular video, in this particular session of this training. We want to push this product so people that will buy it. That's why we needed to have a Facebook page. That's why we needed to the product itself. Okay. So what we actually downloaded that particular video is to use it for our video ads. All right, to use that video as our video ads. So what I'm gonna be doing here is towards proceed. All right. So here, like, you put your ad set name. All right. Of course, you have to leave it as websites, you know, because that's what we're gonna be doing. All right. So, of course, you don't leave it at WhatsApp at website. You don't change it. All right. So what's the next thing there? Dynamic creative, you don't need all those stuff. The major thing you need here is your daily budget, how much you want to spend on your daily basis, on daily basis on Facebook. All right, how much you want to spend is quite important. All right, or rather, how much you spend is very important. All right, let's see it this way. Let me just give us a logical representation of how it works. the more money you give to Facebook, the more money, the more persons, the more audience he reaches for you. The less money you give to him, or rather to Facebook, the less audience you can get. All right, so they are both proportional. The higher the money, the higher the audience. All right, the lower the money, the lower the audience. So it's up to you to know if you want to get a big audience or you want to get a small audience. All right, so for instance, yeah, I would recommend you start maybe your ad with maybe 3-5, or maybe you can actually start with 500, you can start with 1,000, but of course I've given you the idea that this is how it works. So whichever amount of money you feel like, it's okay for you to start. All right, but don't, Facebook is not a magic. Don't expect to run Facebook ad for 500 naira daily and you want to start making hundreds of sales. You might be so lucky enough to have an order in that within the 24 hours, all right? But that doesn't make that that's how it works, okay? You just have to be creative and, you know, think out of the box. So we can just call daily budget. Let's just call it 5,000 in this case, okay, guys? All right, 5,000 for our daily budget, okay? Of course, you can want to set a particular date to want this hour to run, all right? You might want it to run from today's 18th to maybe the next 7 days, all right? You might want to do that. You can just call me and select the dates and all that stuff. I can simply just allow the ads to run, all right? So while we come here with we have to select the audience. So the very first thing we need to do is that the people who are selling this product, where are they? All right, that's the first thing, guys. Are you communicating? I hope I'm making sense to us, guys. The people we are selling this product, where are they? All right, that's the first question you need to ask yourself. That's why I told us before, and that having a product, you need to understand your audience. You don't just go and rush and buy product and expect to start making sales, okay? Make sure you really have an audience for that product you want to buy. This is one of the top, this is the top secret I'm giving. In fact, this is one of the secrets many e-commerce guys do, you know, they preserve to themselves, all right? Before you ever import a product, make sure you have an audience for it. You don't want to have products that will be stocked at home, all right? You don't want to have a product that once you buy it, the next day you can't find any pieces of it. So I repeat again, before you import a product, be very sure that you have an audience. Audience mean people that are ready, people that can buy it, people that are willing to buy it, people that need it, people that are having a problem that product is going to be solution to. You need them, all right? So of course, we are Nigerian. For now, we wouldn't be doing international dropshipping or rather selling to other countries. Let's first of all do in Nigeria, all right? So the people you are selling to is Nigeria, right? So of course, you know the product you are selling. From what age to what age with that product, which age bracket would that product fit in very well? All right, this is left for you to actually know what you're dealing with. All right, your product should tell you that this product should go between these people and these people. For instance, if you're selling a perfume or wristwatch, all right, that's not how you want to target people at let's say maybe 65 even. All right, what were they going to be doing with wristwatch? What are they going to be doing with perfume? All right, those things don't matter to them. That's why you need to be specific about your audience. All right, so another thing I want us to understand is gender. All right, there are products that are only for female, there are products that are only for male. All right, so if you're selling a female product only, you might just want to call me and select only women. Okay, if you're selling both products of men and women, select both of them. If you're selling for men only, select men. All right, so while on detailed targeting, this is where we narrow the people who want to sell this product. Okay, so our product here, we choose what spoon brush. Okay, so now we want to target our audience. Okay, we want to target our audience. All right, so first of all, we want to target our audience. So like I've told us, we need to know our audience. So which people are likely to buy this? Of course, one of the things, people that definitely want to be interested to buy your product are online shoppers, people that shop very well online. Okay, online shoppers, online shopping, blah blah blah, people as of such, online shopping, they're going to buy your product. And what do you call them, discounts, what again now? Oops. discount stores, discount purchase discounts, right? These are likely pages and or interest of people that are likely to buy your product, all right? And of course, you might want to also sell this product to dry cleaners, or if I want to call the is it dry cleaners now? Launderers, cleaners rather. Yeah, people that clean people's house, they want to need that stuff for their business. Okay, so now look here. I believe you'll see me on this pointer, and look at the audience for that particular size of people in this list. About 18 million persons, all right, are under cleaners, all right. And to this, the target house cleaners, of course, you can say window cleaners, janitor, exactly. These are people that are gonna be needing that product. These are your audience, all right. These are your audience that are gonna be needing that particular product. So these are you target all these persons, and you'd target all of them. Hold on, guys. Janitor, all of them, target this person. These are people that will need your product. All right. After you've done that, and of course, this is your where you put your placements. Automatic placement means that Facebook automatically would have to display your ad almost on all of their advertising, platform and all that. But at times, you might want to have your products, to be to be displayed on specific places, okay? Just for your own personal use. You don't want it to be on Facebook Audience Network or Instagram or Messenger. Just want it alone to be on Facebook, right? That means you check all these ones, all right? So that you find out your products are going to be only active on Facebook, okay? So again here, you come here. Of course, you don't want to have app and site, all right? But it's already ticked off, all right? Just go through them and understand what your business represents, and work with that. You don't need in-stream, except of course you can see what in-stream means. Quickly capture people's attention while they're watching videos. So just for you to know where you want your ads to be seen, but most importantly, your ads should be seen on Facebook. If you have an Instagram account, I recommend you put that as well. Okay, so all right, with this we could go to the next option, the next page and all that. All right, so we could go to the next page. You don't mind this, we're gonna fix it soon. So this way you now put, all right, if you have a Instagram account, to connect it right away. All right, so this way we're gonna be using the video you had uploaded, you have downloaded. So what we do is to what, come here, add video, because we want to use video, okay? Video for that particular advertisement. So hold on, guys, let me just import this video from my gallery. Just a minute. Okay, guys, we have imported the video. All right, this is a hurricane spin brochure. So what we do is to continue. All right, so of course, if you look here, there's a video, right? So this is like the preview of how ads gonna look like, right? So what you have to do here is to, of course, guys, I must tell us the truth, you must learn how to write a very good copy for any product you are selling, right? Because that's where the major conversion, like, of course, for persons to come and buy your product. This way you have to start convincing them, hello, look, this, my product is awesome, you're gonna have to buy the product, blah blah blah. So I can just come up with a very good copy. There are persons that write copies, all right. I can have friends that actually are very good at copies. I mean, they are copywriters and they can give excellent jobs. Or me myself, I don't write my copies, I write my copies rather, but I still pay and get my friends to write mine for me. Okay, so what I want us to do is to be able to give a compelling copy, a copy that would make someone to buy your products without having a second thought. All right, so just gonna have to put up something here that when someone sees it, they are already thinking of how do I make a purchase. They're not thinking of any other thing. So that's the reason for a good copy. All right, so for instance, this is what you're dealing with. what's it called? Spin brusher. I believe you must have watched this video to see what the spin brusher does. All right, so it can just be like, aren't you tired of using hands to scrub? All right, to scrub. I'm sure you don't want your nails to break off. Of course, just give them the first of all, the copy should come in a way that you would present their problems to them. All right, that's the first thing you bring out in a copy. You'd be able to show them, okay, this is a problem you're having. All right, so after that, the few other lines should come up with the solution you think that would be okay for the current problem they are facing. All right, so you'd be like, okay, all right, hurricane, stuff like that, spin brusher. Spin scrub rather is here. Oops. Easier to help you. All right. This is blah blah blah. What we can spin brush does and all that stuff and all that stuff. A good copy that we'll be able to compel and convince them to buy. All right. So after doing that, of course, you can just, if you're doing delivery, free delivery, you can just call me and say, free delivery, because Nigerians, we like things that are free, free delivery slash Webio. Hold on, guys. Hold on. Okay, thank you. Supposed to be in the other line. Free delivery, slash Webio, discount of maybe 50% discount. This would also, help your audience to make a purchase of whatever you're selling to them. This is supposed to actually appear at this end. Hold on, guys. Let me. I don't know what's going on tonight. I don't know. It was supposed to be appearing here. All right. So after that, just you don't need a major of these ones. I need them. So what you're gonna do is what now? Since we don't have a website, all right, that's no problem. That's why we need to use Facebook. We need to use WhatsApp as our landing page, right, where people land after they have clicked on our ad. Okay. So to do this, you can just simply, of course, if you want them to land directly to your DM, you can just use something like HTTPS, HTTP. Hold on, guys. HTTP, oops, HTTP. Right, wa.me. Okay, slash 234, your number. Right, 81, blah blah blah. 33462 is my number. Right, with this we can so when I save this now, when someone sees my ad, if they click on this ad, all right, they would be directed to me. Okay, so what I'm gonna have to do is to send a shop now. All right, that's what I want them, what I want to see here. I don't want to see them more here, so I want to see shop now to actually let them to know that this is a shopping, kind of site or stuff like that. So imagine this is how my ad is gonna look like, guys. All right, so you see what I'm saying here? Okay, free delivery and all that stuff. I mean, when you see something like free delivery, Webio, that's not how you wanna. You definitely would be interested to get it. All right, you'll be interested to get it, guys. And of course, so did just it, guys. So I believe I've been able to, so after doing the video, after I've done it, so what you do is to publish it. After you've published it, I'm not publishing this yet, guys, because I'm not running this ad, all right? After you've published it, Facebook will have to review your ad. If they approve it, your ad will be active, all right? And sales will start coming up, all right? So that's it, guys, and I so much believe, and I hope that I was able to pass out some vital information. Right, so don't hesitate to chat me if you have any question, guys. My DM is always open for question. Right, I'll really be so happy that I'll be so happy to get questions from you guys. Anyway, you feel like there you need more clarity and more clarification, I'm here to help us. All right, these once again Christopher Michael. All right, I'm the all right. Let's not go into that, guys. But I just need to see results. All right. Thank you. See you also in the next video. Thank you, guys.